Hello all, and welcome back to DEP TV. It's lovely to see you all again, and thank you very much for coming back. Today we're going to be fitting a dash cam. We're going to be hardwiring a dash cam into a BMW 220D convertible, also known as an F23. We're going to be hardwiring it. We're going to try and hide the wires as much as we can, because I don't want to be using the 12 volt power outlet down there, because I use that for other things, and it's handy there's other people in the car. They've got maybe different connectors, they can just do that, because obviously with my BMW, you can link your phone direct to the car. But anyway, that's another story for another day. So we're going to get this dash cam put in. I'm going to show you where to find the fuse box, which fuses to use, the best place to put your ground, how to route your cables through to the cab, and we're going to show you it all working and all that kind of lovely stuff. So stick about. I'm in the car now, as you can probably see. And lovely BMW 220D, which actually needs a clean, so I can see another video coming. But yep, this here is what we're going to be installing. So let's get into it and I'll show you how we put it in. So here we are, guys. This is what you're going to need. You're going to need a BMW F23. Because this is a specific video for that car, and you're going to need some tools. Now, you're not going to need all of these tools, but I have them just in case. So we have the fitting adapter for the dash cam, we have some connectors, we have some more connectors, and we have a load of spare fuses. Now, I'm already halfway through this job, but I thought I wanted to share it with you. So, when you open the bonnet, this is what you're going to be faced with. And the bit that you're going to be working in is just in here. So in here we have a cowling cover. So underneath here is the front fuse box for the BMW 2 Series, or the F23 version that we're working on today. So what we need to do is we need to remove this. And to remove this, there's not much to it at all, guys. All you need to do is you need to move this weather stripping back. And down here, there is a little clip. Pinch in the clip, and you can see that there. So you've got the clip down here, pinch in the clip, pull it up, and the whole thing will come off. And then you'll be left with your fuse box. So guys, like I said, I'm halfway through this job already. But what you want to do is you want to, there's a clip on the front here, a clip on the front here, and there's two clips at the back. So you push in the two, up it comes, push in those two, and it will come off, and you will be left with this, which is the fuse box in the bonnet area, or the hood area, depending on where in the world you're watching this. If you are in a left-hand drive car, then the fuse box will be on that side. If you're in a right-hand drive car, the fuse box is on this side. We are in the UK, so it's a right-hand drive car, so the fuse box is on this side here. So there's two switches in here that I've identified, which are switched fuses, which is the second one from the bottom here. It's a 5-amp fuse, and this one up here, which is a 30-amp fuse. That's a larger type fuse, and that's a smaller type fuse. But these two here, that one, are both switched fuses, so they will turn off when the ignition is turned off and turn on when the ignition turns on. Please ignore this red wire. Like I said, at the moment, I'm in the middle of fitting this. Now, obviously, you're going to have a positive and you're going to have a negative. Now, I've found different points in this vehicle to put the negative onto. Some people might try this down here. Don't try that. It doesn't work. It's actually rubber, there's a rubber bush under there, rubber insulated, and for some reason I couldn't get a good ground connection on this one. So what I had to do was, if you move down here to the brace, which goes along here, I just loosened off this one here. There's a small connector on the bottom, a little spade connector that I got out of the box that has the negative into it, and then it's just screwed it down, and that's given me a really good ground, a really good negative connection. So the positive connection. Why do I have a cable coming out? Well, let me show you. So originally I was using this, which was the proper fixing kit for it. Now, as you can see, because I've had to cut it off at one end, that one there. But the problem we have is, and I'll show you this very, very quickly. Once you put the, that's the wrong one. Once you put the connector into the fuse box, we'll just put that one in there as a temporary fix. So that can go in like so. Once you put that in there, get all your cables where you want them to be, the lid that lid will not seal down. It will not clip in and it will not seal down. So what I've had to do, and it's going to be very controversial, I know, but I've absolutely no other way of fitting this at the moment, is I removed this fuse here, stripped back this cable, put the cable in there, pushed in the fuse. It's not ideal, I'll be perfectly honest with you, but if I use the fitting kit, I can't get it closed. And that has to be weather tight, it has to be weather sealed, because it's electrics. So these had to come out, and that had to be connected on there. If you have any other ideas, guys, let me know. It would be much appreciated, but at the moment, that's the only way I can think of doing it. So the positive is in the second one across, which is a 5-amp fuse. The negative runs all the way through this, under this rubber here, which goes into the negative connection, which is there. So the next thing you've got to do after that is you've got to get your cables through to your car somehow. And mine, this is the main connection here. This will go through underneath. I don't know if you can see that. It goes in through there, underneath this weather sheeting, through here, and pops out here. But I'll very, very shortly show you how I put all this up there and we get it all hidden away. So before we tidy all these cables up, I'm going to show you something in the bonnet as well, but the cable's currently connected up to the dash cam, so we're going to give it a bit of power just to make sure everything's working fine. Power on. Power light, the dash cam is on. Dash cam lights up, and there we go. We have a dash cam. So we turn the power off. And the dash cam should, if I've done this right, there we go. Off it goes. So what we're going to do is we're going to go back underneath the bonnet just now. We're going to tidy up a wee bit in there, get a couple of wee things done. Why we've got the cowlings off, you can give them a bit of a clean and stuff like that, and we'll put all that back together, and then we'll come back in here and I'll show you how we route the cables up and around here, which is actually quite difficult in a convertible because these are cheap nasty plastic, to be fair. And let's get this cover on, so make sure these wires are all out the way a wee bit. I'm going to tie these up, I think, put a wee bit of tape around that. Around the edge, we've routed that around the corner there, so it shouldn't cause any issues. There we go. And where we've got the cowling off, which is this one here, I think we'll get a little bit of Infinity Wax plastic wax, and we will get the whole of this with a coat of plastic wax on it, just to make it all nice and lovely. Way too much. So there we have it, that's under the bonnet stuff finished. So we're going to head to the side of the motor and I'll show you how I route the cables. Now there is going to be a little cable on show, but there's nothing much I can do about that without spending hours and hours feeding it through the bulkhead and stuff, which I'm not prepared to do because if we ever sell this car, I need to be able to take that, I need to be able to take that dash cam out in minutes. I don't want to spend hours taking it out. So take her inside the car, I'll show you how I hide all the cables. Right guys, so first things first, we want to get this cable in behind this weather stripping, so I'm going to take it out of this dash cam, and what we're going to do is just going to pull at the weather stripping. So we're just going to pull at it. So pull, that's all we need. So pull this through the back. Now, it looks like when you put this in, it's going to bend, and it is. It's going to bend. But 9 times out of 10, the outer sheath on the cable for these dash cams is pretty thick, so it's not going to cause any major issue. This being in here also isn't really going to cause any bit of an issue. Some people are going to go in the comments and say that's going to let water in. Well, do you know what, guys? I've been doing this for years and I've never had water coming in. So anyway, so we get that and we just wrap it round slightly, and then we're going to get this and we're going to push it back on. So that will lock, you see that move there? That's going to lock that into position. And it's going to have our cable through on here. So what we're going to do is I'm going to run my finger. Which finger am I going to use? I don't know yet. And that's going to go like that. And we're just going to feed that up there. That pushes into a little gap that's at the back. Cable is hidden, apart from this bit here. But to be honest, guys, there isn't much we can do about it. And there's a little bit of rubber here, which is going to cover that anyway. So now I'm just going to bring in a little bit closer. And I'm going to show you how I put the cable in and around this bit here so that we can kind of hide it a wee bit better, so it's not as noticeable. So what we're going to do, guys, because we're in an F23, which is the convertible roof, that's why we've got a fabric roof up here, we're going to try to hide the cable as best we can in this little groove, which is in here. Now, it fits in, it's about the same size, it will push in, but it's not going to disappear completely. I don't particularly want to rip all this off at the moment, because I've just got all the cable hidden in behind there. If we have to, we have to, but we'll see. We'll see if we can get away without doing that. We'll see if we can push it in with a little tool, and we'll see if we can get this cable hidden up here. And that will kind of give us the length of where the camera's going to go. Now, I think anywhere along here is fine for me for the camera. I don't really mind. Preferably within the sweep of the wipers would be ideal. But I'm going to see if I can get this in here, and if I can't, I'm going to have to try and pull this off. We should just be on clips, then we can get the cable right in behind and get it hidden again. Well, that wasn't working. So what we're going to do, it won't go in, it won't fit in behind. So I'm going to try and hopefully get it out of a gap up here. So what we're going to do is we're going to pull this down a wee bit, try and get behind it. I should really have my tool out for this, but...
It was at this point he knew he'd messed up.
So yeah, you can probably notice that I broke the microphone receiver at this point. But what I've done is I've managed to pull it off. Now you'll notice there's a gap behind there and there's a green clip at the top. So what we're going to do is we're going to feed the wire right up the inside of the plastic A-pillar, and we're going to make sure it's on the top end of that green clip, so that the cable comes out right in that top corner. That's what we're looking for. So now we're going to get all the cables tucked up nicely behind, put it over the top. It's a little bit fiddly, this, because sometimes the cable can start to bend inside, and also we're having to make sure we keep the water rubber, the door seal, should I say. We're trying to keep that out the road as well. So anyway, get it all where you want it. And just get the back of your hand, the palm of your hand, and just give it a quick knock once it's all in some sort of position. So what we're doing here is we're just trying to make sure everything's on the right side of the rubber. Side of the hand, palm of the hand, whatever you want, just give it a quick clip in. Just, you'll feel it clip in. Just make sure there's nothing untoward fell out or anything. You're going to have to pull that back off and make sure you've not snapped any clips or anything like that. And then once it's coming out the top corner, we're going to feed it across the top, as you can see there. But when you feed it in across the top, you just get your fingers, just push it up in between the gap between the top plastic bit and the glass. As you can see right there, there's a little bit showing, but we'll get onto that towards the end of the video. So yeah, that's it, more or less installed. As you can see, I hadn't pushed it up far enough so it fell out. But what it also does is it gives us an idea of where the actual camera is going to go, and you can adjust it if you don't think it's in the right position. But we're going to move this slightly across to the left, and then we'll get onto that one.
So guys, we're back in the car again. So the cables are all hidden away.
down there, nobody would know they were there. There's a slight little bit here, but that's it's hidden behind the black bit in the windscreen. But it's just so tight to the windscreen, I don't want to break anything, so leave that there as it is. It's hidden all the way up the back of here. Just make sure it's all in. Yep, we're all in. So what we're going to do is we're going to go down here, we're going to press some power, make sure it comes on, turn the power off, make sure it goes off, and that is the installation done for this dash cam. Let's get some power again. Power on. Wee lights on the dash cam. We have power. Now we can just adjust it as we want. If we want it further down, we want it further up, we want to move it across, we want to move it that way, it doesn't matter, you can put it wherever you like. This one does have a rear view camera in it as well, but I'm not fitting that because convertible and it's plastic and there's no way to screw it into. So there you go guys, that is how to install a dash cam in a BMW F23, which is a 2 series convertible. Like I say, it's going to be a little bit controversial because I couldn't use the fitting kit, but I do want a hardwired system. I don't want one that takes up the power, the 12 volt power outlet in the car, because I use that for other things. So it's installed, it works, there's no errors on the dashboard, everything works absolutely fine. It comes on with the power, it goes off with the power. What more can you want from a dash cam, I suppose? You don't want it on all the time, because it will drain your battery if it's on overnight. You can set the dash cam, if this one particular anyway, you can set the dash cam to stay on for X amount of time when the power's turned off. This one just goes off with the power and that's it done. So we've done that, that's all connected under the bonnet, but we gave the bonnet a little spruce up as well using some plastic and rubber wax from Infinity Wax. But that is it, video is done. Thank you very much for watching guys. If you wouldn't mind, a wee subscribe, a like, a share, would be absolutely fantastic if you can. Thank you very much for watching again, guys, but it's time to go!